shall be of sufficient clarity to indicate the location. So number one, information, location of the project, nature and extent of the work, nature and extent. What is the limitation in the scope of the project? Is it only the repair and maintenance? Is it only amendment? Or it is a new design, a new project? So it must be indicated on the specification of plan, showing details, conformance with the provision of this code. So it is, of course, necessary to include the sentence that this plumbing design conforms to NPCP 1999, for example, okay? Or local ordinance. There are ordinance for every municipality or cities like Taguig City pertaining to this. Technical specification submitted shall comply with the provision of existing national building code and this code. Okay, section chapter 1, number 3, so 103, permit is shown. So after a while, the OBO will check your plan, specifically the OBO / master plumber, and then checked by the head of the office of the building official, and then return back to you as approved or disapproved. It can be disapproved, then therefore you have to resubmit, recheck, redesign, redo your drawing, modify. Okay, then until such time that the design is marked approved, there is a again printed or stamped approved by the building official. Okay. Administrative authority may issue a partial permit for construction as part of the law. For example, the building official cannot check the plan easily because the building is so big or so high that there are plenty of plumbing pages, right? So they may need several days to check, and therefore they may try to issue temporary for initial work indicated. No? So the total work done may be divided into several portions, and then issue temporary permit for each of the smaller work scope. Okay? And next, retention of plans. One set of approved plans out of the 6 copies, one set shall be retained by the building official. So one set. So there are other 5 sets. And again, 2 sets approved plans and data shall be returned to the applicant. Okay? 2 sets to the applicant. So there are 3. And owner to the applicant and owner. And one set of which shall be kept at the job site. So sa site, one set. So there are only 4. But the requirement of the law is 6. So the law indicated 4 specific purpose of the copy. So for owner and applicant, 2 copies. For the for the job site, 1 copy. And for the building official, 1 copy. So 4. So this is indicated on the law and usually being regularly asked in the board exam. It is a very common question in the board exam. Example of question in the board exam that use this. Therefore, the other 2 extra copies is going to blank. Letter A. But those are not indicated in the law. There are only 4 copies that have indicated purpose. But the question in the board exam is, therefore, the other 2 copies, this is not indicated in the law, is going to where? Letter A. Letter B. Possible. Again. Letter C. Again, possible answer. Letter D. Again, possible. Therefore, you are now confused. Okay? So this is a point of every, almost every board exam in Pastor Clavel. So you have to what? To think of the whole picture. Maybe the job site is what? Needing more copies, no? Not only one copy. Because, for example, there are several floors. One job site may involve what? Several foreman for each and every floor. Foreman for first floor, second floor, third floor. And therefore, there are several copies of plan. Okay? So you have to think out of the box. Next is validity of the permit. Okay. If the permit is given, how long it should be valid? Okay. The issuance of this, by the provision of this code, this is shall not prevent the authority from thereafter requiring the correction of errors on said plans, specification, and other documents from stopping an ongoing plumbing installation, violative of this code, or other pertinent ordinances of the jurisdiction. So, very big. Very big, it's not specific. It gives so much authority and so much power to building official. So he can stop your work. He said, our permission is what? Temporarily void. So recall. They can recall their permit. So you can what? Cannot argue about this because it is provided by law. And therefore, the work on plumbing system shall be stopped. Expiration. It is what? If the plumbing work authorized is not commenced within 1 year, so you applied for the permit, but the work did not start and take a long time and 1 year, after which you have to reapply for the permit. So the validity of permit is 1 year for you to start. You must start within 1 year. So, and if you started within 1 year, the permit is valid. And if you what? Temporarily stop operation for 120 days. What is 120 days? 4 months. If there is a suspension of work, so for example, this building, more than 4 months stop operation due to what? Election. So dapat meron siyang additional permission ng building na yan, that new building. So, that is not a problem for Taguig City because the applicant is Taguig City and the building official is Taguig City. So, can be easily done. So, how's it done? Okay, so wala na time. So, we'll just continue with the section 4. So, we are through with section 3. So, section 4, let's continue next meeting. Any question? So, at least there is only what? 2 pages for the chapter 1. So, they are what? 1.5 chapters finished today. Okay, so, bring plans so that we can what? We can shift back and forth from code to computation. So 3 hours of essay and law studies is 2 months. No? So there must be what? Some computation then go back to code. No? Okay? Anyway, this is true for today. So don't forget to like and subscribe.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for the activities.
Shout out
to Engineer Capua.
Engineer Tickling.